Okay, we've talked a lot about this, but we have never talked about the process of you actually getting into that makeup. What was that like?
That was pretty grueling. Okay. I mean, it started at six and a half hours getting into that makeup. Well, and they were still kind of making decisions, you know, on what was going on with it. We worked it down to 3.5 hours.
That's still a long time.
Yeah, that's where it lived. So, and it was like kind of like Chinese water torture. So it was like glue torture. I mean, it's just this meticulous process that, I mean, it's torturous. It, it kind of was ironic, you know, to me to discover all these years that the only person really being tortured on these sets was Robert Englund.
Exactly. Well, did it put you in more of like a mean frame of mind to get into that?
Hey, what?
A mean frame of mind? You're in a bad state when you're in that makeup?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Actually, the whole, the feeling of this stuff was so cumbersome, and it was almost otherworldly.
Yeah.
Because I would have fake fingertips over here, the knives over here, all of this glue, and then they put a contact lens in that I couldn't see out of this eye. I could barely see out of this one.
Yeah.
So I kind of would withdraw inside until they needed me, and it was like, it was otherworldly. So to me, that's how Freddy feels.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I would give him that between action and cut, and it's just, I mean, I can't even describe. It's the oddest thing. It's,
well, you've done it once. Would you do it again?
You know, I think if the film does real well and they want to do a sequel, they've got me for a couple more, so we'll, let's see how it goes.
That would be awesome. Tell me what sets this nightmare apart from the other nightmares.
You know, I think one of the things that really set it apart is 2010 sensibilities, but yet still paying homage to the great sensibilities back then, so dialing it in. But one of the things is this is, it's a much bigger film. You know, I think back, you know, in the mid-80s, that first film, what was partly what was so great about it is knowing that Wes did it for like $1.50, you know? And so it would be hard to kind of recapture that. So, you know, Sam took it to that next level. It's almost like, you know, I can't help but wonder what Wes will think when he sees this in terms of like, wow, I wish I had that kind of, I'm wondering if he wished he had that kind of budget when he did it, you know?
Thomas was saying that this is a much darker, it takes the story into a much deeper, darker place than it ever has taken it before, and that he thinks maybe now we're ready to accept the backstory. Do you think that's true? The character's backstory, like Freddy, we never really heard all the things that took him to where he was, but we actually do learn that in this one?
I think, yeah, they kind of get after it in a little bit more, in a little bit more detail and stuff like that. So, but at the same time, it's not, you know, they're not over-laboring it. I think it's just helps to kind of add, you know, add a little bit more tension, a little bit more depth to what's going on. It helps to raise the stakes with what's going on with our young actors as they travel through the film. So.
Yeah. Now, Sam has never directed a feature film before. He's always done music videos. Could you tell when you're on the set, or did it matter at all?
I think Sam did a great job. Yeah, the film looks really good, and I think what he got after, you know, a lot of the film I wasn't even around. You know, it's Rooney and driving this movie with Kyle, and man, they did a really good job. And not just them, I mean, Thomas and Katie and Kellen, everybody was just like really awesome in this.
And also, everybody else was telling me they signed on to this movie because of you. How does that feel?
Wow.
That's
like,
said that.
That's like unreal. That's like, I can't, that's, it kind of gives me chills when, yeah.